For audiences that haven't seen the film, can you just tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, the film is a really amazing, raw, emotional portrait of Mario Hemingway, and it looks at the Hemingway family in a way that you've just never seen before. And also with the footage that we found of Margot Hemingway, it feels like you know her so well. She just eats up the screen and reveals so many intimate and beautiful things.
And what inspired you to want to tell this story?
Well, somebody called and said, how would you like to do a film on the Hemingways? And I thought, this is amazing. I would love to. And I met with Mario and I said, if you're going to be open and you're going to do it, I will do it. And she said, I'll tell you everything. And she told me some things I didn't even want to know.
Oh, really? And are they in the film?
Yes.
So we all know now.
Yes. Yes.
And, I mean, you're documenting a hugely well-known family and legacy.
So you think.
So we think. Were there any challenges for you having to tackle that?
Well, I think we just wanted to tell an honest, beautiful story. I mean, Ernest is one of the best authors of the 20th century. He loves women, he loves hunting, he loves fishing. I mean, many of my films deal sort of with men, like Gregory Peck, Mike Tyson, you know, others. And I think you just want to figure out who they are. But for Ernest, he couldn't deal with his demons. He could deal with everything else but that.
And in terms of the exploratory process and the revelations that have come out of this, how did Mario deal with that? And, you know, what new things did she learn about herself?
I think this was an exploration for her, for transformation and for hope. And so she's continually learning. And she's got that same Hemingway drive, except not with drinking. She plunges into cold water. She climbs up mountains with her bare hands. And she's amazing.
She's amazing. Yeah. Did you have any kind of any problems with any of the other Hemingway family members in terms of getting this made?
It's really a tale of three sisters and Mario's daughters. So no.
Okay. And what would you like audiences to take away from this?
That we need to talk about mental illness, that we need to end the taboo, and we used to never be able to talk about AIDS or breast cancer, and we have to be able to do that, because the only way we're going to succeed is by helping each other.
And
we're all inflicted with it. We all know somebody.
Absolutely. And you've won 2 Academy Awards. You swept the board at Sundance. What's next?
More wonderful films.
Yeah. Have you got any projects
to share? Yes, we do.
Are you able to talk about them?
Not yet.
Not yet. Okay, fair
but
enough.
Yes.
Okay. And just finally, how important is it to bring it here to Sundance London?
It's amazing. This is our premiere, and I love London. I filmed Wild Man Blues, a lot of Wild Man Blues, Woody Allen's film here, and the people are great, and I hope the audiences will be the same.
Wonderful. I'm sure we'll love it. Thank you very much, Barbara. Congratulations.
I've worked with Barbara for quite a while now, but when you have an opportunity to bring a new understanding to a famous family, everyone knows the name Ernest Hemingway, but there is a lineage that has gone from generation to generation to generation that really hasn't been told, and we were given an opportunity to tell that. And as storytellers and filmmakers, that's the kind of opportunity you can't say no to.
How did your personal perception of the Hemingways change as this process evolved?
Ernest Hemingway is a myth, but he's really just a man. And what he handed down to his family are very human problems. And we were able to explore them, and we were able to bring a new understanding to this family and what they've been through over these generations. And the fact that, you know, they are breaking the cycle. Marielle Hemingway has found a way through her lifestyle to say, I'm not going to be another casualty of expectation.
And Marielle goes through, I mean, she's had quite an up and down, turbulent life. I mean, how easy was it to kind of bring all of this roller coaster to the big screen?
Okay. Creating a documentary is not the easiest thing. We have characters that have passed, and we had to bring them back to life. And we fortunately were able to uncover some really significant archival footage that I really think adds a dynamic to this film that gives it a real understanding of what it is to suffer through mental illness and what ultimately leads to someone to take their own life. And what I think is most amazing is I believe that Marielle, through this process, she gave such an she gave us so much access. She was an open book. It's a real compliment to do that on camera. And she learned something new about her sisters. She learned something new about her family in the process. And I think that's a compliment to us as filmmakers, but more so to her for being so involved in the process and so open to us.
And do you think she learned something about herself as well?
I think Marielle is a very self-aware person. She's very open about the fact that she has had her own struggles and that she's in a very good spot. She's very healthy, and she had took her a long time to get there. I think that she's someone who believes that she's constantly learning. She is a student of life, and I don't think that's ever going to change. Even though the fact is that she has something really wonderful to share today, tomorrow she'll have even more to share, and she's constantly evolving as a human being, and she's a really great person.
And what's her reaction to the film been?
You know, Marielle was overwhelmed by the film in a lot of ways. You know, some of the footage that we brought of her father and of her mother, she really needed to come to her own conclusion. She was wondering, did these things happen? Was the paint on the wall in my parents' kitchen that color? Did my mom really sit on the counter every day? And then she saw it all because we found this footage that she didn't see until the first time she saw the film. She didn't know we had it. And she said, look, it's all there. And then I think the nicest compliment that we've been paid is that she said, Marielle told us that I can now share my parents with my daughters. They've never met them. They never had a chance to know who they are and what they looked like and what their mannerisms were. And thanks to this process and going through it with us, she was able to share something really beautiful with her daughters.
Sounds very rewarding. What would you like, particularly a British audience, to take away from this?
You know, it's okay to talk about mental illness. It's okay to talk about suicide, and it's okay to break from the paths that people prescribe to us. There is no one way to live our lives. And I really would hope that people can say after seeing a film like this that it's a good thing to talk about. This is a very tough subject. It was a tough film to make because of this subject. Thankfully, we had a main character who offers so much hope, and she has so much energy. And I would hope that people can say after seeing it that we can talk about it. And talking about it is the first step. You know, we didn't talk about a lot of things for a long time. It was taboo to talk about AIDS. It was taboo to talk about gun violence in the U.S. It's taboo to talk about a lot of things. You know, well, right now it's still taboo to talk about mental illness. And anything that we can do to add to a conversation for people to be able to say, you know what, here's a spot for us to start talking about it. You know, that'd be really rewarding. That's what I'd hope people could take away from it.
And just finally, so you've worked with Barbara quite a few times. What's she like to work with?
Oh, well, I was a penniless graduate of college, and I sought Barbara out 11 years ago because I wanted to learn from a master storyteller. And I can say undoubtedly that I am still a student of Barbara Koppel. She is one of the best storytellers in the business. There is no doubt about that. And it's a rewarding day in and day out. I'm constantly learning something new. Thankfully, I think it's a little bit less because I have picked up a few lessons along the way. But Barbara Koppel is a master of talent of story.